Good morning once again and welcome back to my channel. My name is Doris. There are people in your life that have been bringing accusations against you. Before we get into this word, let us pray. Father, I thank you. I bless you. I glorify your name, Lord. Thank you for yet another opportunity to share your word. I pray that this word is going to be a blessing. It's going to be an encouragement and a revelation to somebody. Lord, anoint your word even as I release it. I pray that whoever is going to hear this word, Lord, they shall hear that which you are saying in this hour. They shall not hear me, but they shall hear you, Lord, even as you minister to them. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Like I said, there are people in your life who have been trying to bring accusations against you. They have been digging in your past, trying to get some mistakes that you did in the past, something that you did wrong in the past, and they want to use it against you. They want to undermine your character. They want to undermine your integrity and portray you as somebody who lacks character, as somebody who lacks integrity. For some of you, it is already happening, but for some of you, it has been going on behind your back, and you are gonna be seeing it in your life. You see, there are these people in your life that the enemy has been using to bring accusations against you and to slander you. The devil is the accuser of the brethren and uses human agents to do his dirty work here on earth. You see, the agenda is to drain you emotionally. They want you frustrated. They want you distressed so that you don't focus on what God is doing in your life. The accusations are targeted to distract you. Now listen, the only advantage that the enemy has against you is lack of knowledge and lack of understanding. Once God gives you a revelation, you are gonna be able to beat the enemy at his own game. These people, they think that you don't know what they are doing. They have been piling up things behind your back for a while. It has been going on for a while. They have been trying to undermine you for a while in your workplace, in your ministry, in your family, and this thing has been going on for a while, and they think that you don't know about it. But God is going to give you a revelation of what has been going on. God is even going to show you who these people are and what they have been doing behind your back and what they have been saying behind your back. All the lies that they have been saying behind your back, God is gonna show it to you. Some of you, God is gonna even reveal it to you in your dreams. You are gonna know exactly what has been going on. You see, the enemy, the devil, is the accuser of the brethren, and he's always accusing us of something before the court of heavens. And you must have an understanding of how the court of heavens work. Remember that our warfare, our battle, is not flesh and blood. It is not physical. And so don't focus on the people who are attacking you. See the spirit behind it. See the spirit that is working in them. See the spirit that is working through them, because they are being influenced with a force. That is what you target. Target that thing that is working through them. Shut it down. And when you shut it down, their accusations are gonna, the accusations will not even prevail in your life. It's going to become a non-issue. Once you shut down the spirit, they will be brought to shame and they will be brought to disgrace. In fact, some of them will even come to apologize to you. They will come back to their senses and wonder even why were they doing that? Why were they ganging up with people who are against you to work evil against you? You must rise up and appear in the courts of heavens. The Lord ministered to me that many have been missing in the courts. Instead, you have been so much engulfed with the slander. You have been so much engulfed with the attacks that is being sent against you. You have been so much concerned with trying to find out who are the people who are attacking you, who are the people who are working against you. You have been wondering, why is it that suddenly it seems like there is so much that is working against you, and people all of a sudden seems to be people who are, you are already good with them, they are suddenly like turning against you. Some of you, you have been hearing here and there some things being said about you, and you have been wondering where it is coming from, and you have been so much concerned in trying to find out who it is that is spreading all these lies, that is spreading all these rumors against you. There are those of you who have been appearing in court. There are those of you who have been appearing in court, but you must understand that there are protocols that need to be observed in the courts of heavens. There are protocols that, like, just like in the natural courts, in the courts of heavens, there are natural protocols that need to be observed. You cannot just appear in court anyhow. You must appear in court with the word of God. It is the constitution of heaven, and the enemy and his cohorts are very, very legalistic. The devil will always use scripture against you, especially when you are operating in a certain level spiritually. The enemy will come against you with scripture. He's gonna attack you with scripture. Once you start operating in a certain level spiritually, and these people that have been attacking you, that have been bringing accusations against you, especially those of you who are in ministry, they have been using scripture to justify whatever accusations that they have been bringing against you. And you need to understand this. They have been attacking your character through scripture. They have been attacking your integrity by using scripture. And you must be sensitive to this, because some of you, it may really weigh you down. There are some people that the enemy will just attack them anyhow, whichever way. But then there are others that the enemy is gonna come against you using scripture, because he knows that the level of revelation that you are operating in, it is not surface, it is deep. You have understanding of the word of God, you have revelation, you have knowledge. So he comes to you in a subtle way. He comes to you in a very wise way. When the enemy comes against you, using scripture, know that you are on a whole new level spiritually. You see, he tried this with Jesus and he failed. And there is no reason as to why he must prevail in our lives. He can never prevail in our lives. Jesus is our advocate, and he is saying to you that you must appear in court, and not just appear in court, but observe protocol when you come before the courts of heavens. Jesus went head to head with the enemy, word for word, and he brought him down. You must have the word. I have several passages of scripture that is going to encourage you and help you counter these accusations. Romans 8, 1 and 2, it reads, "There is therefore now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has made me free from the law of sin and death." Colossians 2, 14 and 15, it reads, "Blotting out the handwriting of ordinance that was against us, which was contrary to us, and took it out of the way, nailing it on his cross." You see, it doesn't matter what these people are digging out in your past. God already forgave you. God already blotted it out. It can't work against you anymore. The people bringing accusations against you in their smear campaign to slander you and to tarnish your name and your reputation, it is not gonna work. They have been on a witch hunt, digging your past, digging things from your past. But what they don't know is that Jesus already blotted it out. That handwriting of ordinance against you, that accusation, it has already been blotted out. Jesus dealt with it, and the devil cannot keep on bringing accusations against you for what God has already dealt with. You must stand on the word of God. If there is nothing that the devil can use against you, you are already living in holiness. You are already living a consecrated life unto the Lord. You are living in righteousness. He is gonna try to find something in your bloodline or in your family tree. As a believer, you must always live a repentant life. Scripture says that if we say that we do not have sin, then we deceive ourselves. Colossians 3:13-14 says, Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made a curse for us. For it is written, cursed is everyone that hangs on a tree, that the blessing of Abraham might come on the Gentiles through Jesus Christ, that we might receive the promise of the spirit of faith. It doesn't matter how many times the devil brings up the sins and the iniquities of your past generations, as long as you are living in repentance, it's not gonna stand in the courts of heavens. The accusations are not gonna prevail in your life. Jesus already paid the price for everything. Don't be discouraged. Don't be distracted with the accusations. God has already blotted out the accusations by the blood of Jesus Christ. The Constitution, His word, says that you are free. Whom the Son sets free is free indeed. You are a son in the kingdom and you have your rights. Don't engage your accusers. Don't even try to justify anything that they are saying against you. Don't even try to clear your name or try to explain yourself to people. Just step into the courts of heavens instead with boldness and decree the word of God over your life. Counter the accusations with the word of God. The ruling was made on the cross when the blood cried out, "It is finished." The blood is still speaking over your life today, and it is speaking better and good things. It is countering every accusation and every attack of the enemy. May the Lord abundantly bless you. I love you so much, but the Lord, He loves you so much more. He loves you than everlasting love, and there is nothing that can separate you from His love, which is in Christ Jesus. Blessings and shalom.